Kajabi have just rolled out some exciting new updates, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through them all. I'm going to tell you what's new, how they work, and why they matter for your online business. On the list today, we're going to cover Kajabi's Community Beta. It's got a major update, and it's coming to more people soon. Kajabi Payments is now available in some new locations globally. There's a brand new insights and analytics dashboard for better tracking. The Kajabi coaching product has some great new updates, including a new scheduling widget and some custom reminders and notifications. And very excitingly, we've got a new email folders function to keep your marketing all organized. And I'm going to give you an update on those that are using the branded mobile app. If we haven't met yet, I'm Kate, an online business consultant specializing in Kajabi. I help business owners to simplify their tech, automate smarter, and grow their online offers without the overwhelm. Let's dive into these new Kajabi features. So let's get started by looking at the brand new community feature in Kajabi. Now, I have a group that I use for my testing and training, and I have the new community look. I'm a beta tester in that look, and a few people have been doing that for the past 6 months or so now, and so I'm going to show you now what that community looks like. I'm not going to show you all the functionality of it, just the new improved parts, because if you also have a beta trial, then you'll just want to know what these new updates are. The community is looking to roll out to everybody soon, the new community, because they are opening things up on the 10th of March to anyone that does want to have the new version on their own community in Kajabi, and eventually that will just become the default, but right now it is still in the beta phase, but it looks like it's rolling out towards the end of the beta phase. So let's take a look. So one of the new features that they've just added on is a much easier onboarding experience for new admins of the people that own the community. So what you can see here, I've already skipped through a couple of screens. I'll just go back. This is my new look community, but in the meantime, when I've just jumped into it now, it is asking me to choose a color for my community. So this is just a new onboarding, beautiful looking flow. That means I don't have to go right into the settings to be able to change these things. It's just as I'm jumping in here again. So, and then it's showing me some new and improved navigation. So, some announcements, some challenges, like just how everything looks on the left-hand side, how you can reorder pages, things like that. And it is showing me too that I can add a cover photo to the top of the community, which I already have in there, but it's just showing me where I can add it and how I can change it. So this nice onboarding flow, just stepping me through things, how to add custom links, and the new redesign, just introducing me to it, even though I've already been in it. So here's how it looks. And that onboarding flow is one of the new features of the beta trial at the moment. Okay, so to add some custom icons to everything along the left-hand side here, so that we can kind of customize it, personalize it to our own brand and relevancy, we just, these here are called the circles, or we can do it on the feed as well. So if I just click over here, we'll do it on the feed, go here, I can rename the feed, and I can choose the icon here. So we can call, let's say we want the feed to be, I don't know, a newspaper. Something like that. So we can customize what these look like on the left-hand side now. So you'll see that's there. I'll change this one to a maybe hand waving. Which is that one? Which one is the hand waving? This one. Cool. And then go done. And save. And let's save one of the others. Travel logistics and chats. Let's add a maybe an aeroplane. Or I can go in here and look at icons as well. So if you're wanting to keep it nice and we can change the color of the icons, which is exciting too. Or custom, so you can drag and drop your own icons in here as well if you've got something created. But let's just add a plane to this one, just so we can see how they all look. And location chats. So. We'll add a pin to that one, like that. So I'm inside the actual official Kajabi Community Insiders group at the moment because my group doesn't have enough engagement in it to show you one of the last features that they've just updated as well on this new look. And that is a little bit more functionality in the feed. So it's becoming very similar to like a Facebook style. So previously we didn't have these lines here and we couldn't see the direct replies underneath each one. So this is nice and easy now, for we can see the post and then we can see kind of like the ordered communication as well, where people are commenting and then replying to each other as well. So that's really nice and smooth now for people to look at. Now, I did want to mention, if you are not already in the Insiders community, then make sure you jump in here, because the final thing I want to show you, if you already have a Kajabi community, a community on Kajabi, and you want to have this new look and you don't have it yet, then you can come in here to the Insiders community and you can come to Beta Access, and then, or Beta Access, depending on where you are, and then you can complete the form that's just embedded in here with your details. Literally, I think all you need to add is your name and address, and you will be told when you have access to that, to the new look, and it will instantly switch over and look like my one here. And you'll be able to then go through the process to update those icons and go into the settings area to update anything else you need. All of your content and things will flow through of your existing, just the look will look a little bit different. You'll have to create some images. So for example, each of the chat groups now has the ability to add an image up the top here, which wasn't possible before. This one here, I haven't done it for yet, so you don't have to do it, but where you can go edit page, that's where you can add a cover photo there. But you don't have to do it, you can pick and choose how. And that is all for the updates on the community right now. So the next update I want to talk to you about is Kajabi Payments. Now, Kajabi Payments is starting to roll out across the world. In the past year or two, it is now available in the USA, in Canada, in Australia, and the United Kingdom. And just this last month, they have rolled this out to certain European countries as well, which I'm gonna show you in a minute. But first, I just wanted to explain what Kajabi Payments is, because when you have a Kajabi account, by default, you, of course, can make payment processing through your account. Until Kajabi Payments was invented, what you did was you integrated your account, your Kajabi account, with PayPal and with Stripe. While the checkouts, the front facing part for your customer, is based on Kajabi, the processing happens outside in Stripe or PayPal. And there are certain things that you can do directly in Kajabi, and certain things that you have to go into your Kajabi and your Stripe or PayPal account to administer. So this is why Kajabi now has Kajabi Payments, which is not available everywhere in the world just yet while they're rolling things out. And this is what it includes. So basically, you can do a lot of the same things that you can already do in Kajabi anyway without the Kajabi Payments feature. All of the stuff you can do anyway. However, I think there's a little bit more customization available within the Kajabi account rather than having to log into your Stripe account. Essentially, Kajabi Payments is actually just a white label of Stripe. That is what they're doing. They're partnering with Stripe to be able to just bring out a lot of this in-house. The two big things though that Kajabi Payments allows that's not available just directly on Kajabi is the ability to offer additional payment methods, which at this stage is Afterpay and Klarna. So if I just scroll down here to show you, the ability for your customers to be able to just pay via Afterpay or Klarna, whatever is available in your region once you have Kajabi Payments. And the other thing is the sales tax. So being able to separate out and charge sales tax. At this stage, that's not just available by default, and there are some workarounds within the regular Kajabi. So here goes some information here about all of that, being able to add that tax in, provide the correct receipts, all that sort of stuff. But I'm not gonna show you that right now. What we came here to do was to show you which European countries now have Kajabi Payments available. And basically it looks like it's all of the primary current countries that have the euro is what it's to do with, so the relevant currency. And look at this, it's currently supported now in all of these countries. I believe there have been some people that have been on the beta trial of this, and now it's rolled out to anybody who chooses to use it. You don't have to use Kajabi Payments within your Kajabi account. You can still just use those native Stripe and PayPal integrations. So these are all the countries here to get excited about. Looks like there's some more information here for European countries as well. And you can jump on into the Kajabi Help Center and look that up if you want more detail. So that's super exciting. And to all my New Zealand folk, I'm hoping that we're not far away with Kajabi Payments. As you can see, Australia has it. We thought that we might get lumped in with Australia when they rolled that out. However, Kajabi processing team, of course, finance team, has to be working directly with the individual countries and currencies and banks and legislation. So it's not just as simple as rolling it out country by country, of course. So fingers crossed we've got that soon. I keep chasing Kajabi about it. I'll let you know as soon as we have it, of course. Okay, the next new feature update that I want to show you is this new brand new dashboard. Now this is my test trial account, so there's nothing that's been processed through this account, hence it's looking a little rather sad at zero. But this is a new dashboard sitting up here that you just can have a quick preview of what's going on right now. Switch it between if you want to have a look, you know, just some quick reporting, what's happened in the last 24 hours, 7 days, 30 days, and of course, there is some, and you get a little graph here, of course, but there is further analytics always over here in the analytics tab. So this is just on the front dashboard when you log into Kajabi, a beautiful looking insight into what's been going on in your business on Kajabi in the last 24 hours, 7 days, 30 days. Of course, this is everything to do with the payments that are being processed through Kajabi, not just on Kajabi payments, but also just through your regular Kajabi offers and checkouts as well. If you are processing payments outside of Kajabi, of course that won't show on here, so it may not be a relevant insight to your business, but this is specifically to do with your business on Kajabi, the money that you take through your Kajabi account. So that's super exciting. Of course you can jump into analytics and check that out in a lot more detail, grab some reports. These are all the reports that are available through Kajabi analytics as well. Now this new feature update I am super excited about because this is something that I use in my own business on Kajabi. It's some updates to the coaching product. Now I love the coaching product, but there has been some features that we've been requesting for a little while to make it completely gold standard, and I believe they're here, and there's a couple more on the horizon that are coming as well. So I want to show you today the exciting new scheduling widget. So previously, just to give you some background on Kajabi's scheduler, it was a little bit limited. So Kajabi has its own scheduler and Live Room, which replaces your external booking calendar and Zoom potentially. However, it wasn't fully integrated with a lot of different calendars, and so therefore I didn't use it. I still use my Acuity calendar and my Zoom for my live coaching calls here. However, I've now switched that over due to the new scheduler. I'm going to show you what it looks like. It means now, previously your customer went through a checkout and paid, and then you had to have some automations to send them to your booking calendar if you had an external booking calendar. Now it means your customer can book their time and pay all within the same window on your website, or within your coach, within your product. So if you have a community or a course product, you can have the scheduler sitting right in there so they don't have to move away from anywhere to book. And I'll show you what that looks like on my website here. So this is the product, the sales page for the product that I have set up in the coaching product on Kajabi. So you can click this here and it brings you down to choose which session you would like to do. And when I click, I've also got it sitting right down the bottom here as well. However, that button takes me to here. When I click whether I want a 1 hour or 2 hour session, I click schedule now. And look at this, I can schedule and pay right in the same place. What it also does from the back end on the coach's perspective is when I choose a date and a time like this, and I confirm it, I go through to a payment page. While that payment is pending, so before I've made that payment as a customer, there is currently in my coaching calendar a hold put in there, which means nothing else can be booked over that time. And if I just close this preview link, you'll see up here there is a countdown timer. Now I did a whole video about this on YouTube last week, so you can jump in and find that all about the coaching product, the new widget, and a little bit more of the back end of the coaching product. So I just wanted to quickly show you what that looks like from the front end of my website. And then in the back end of your coaching product on Kajabi here now, there is the ability to, now that I've changed it over to the Kajabi scheduler, I can add in all of my availability, add more availability, so it knows when people can book those times. I can choose the start time increments, so this is going to be every hour on the hour rather than at random times throughout. People can book up to 4 weeks in advance. I've got some buffer time here as well, so I want some time before and after my calls, just like regular scheduling calendars. That's all available here in Kajabi now. I've integrated it with my Google calendar now as well, so that anytime right now, for instance, while that this booking over here is pending before I've made the payment, in my Google Calendar there will be a hold because it's integrated, it's synced with it. And then also within the programs themselves, let's go into the details of the program. I can also individually set some settings based on this program, because if you have multiple coaching programs, you might want to have different kinds of settings for each one. And within here, down the bottom, I can also now set notifications. This is an awesome new update, another update in the coaching product as well. Previously, we didn't have this. So the coaching product on Kajabi has the ability to allow the customer and the coach to make notes. So there's a shared notes section where they can type together, and there's a private notes section for each person as well. Also the ability to add agenda items, resources, things like that. Previously we weren't getting notified. So when my clients added some resources or some notes, I wasn't getting notified of that. So I had to keep jumping into the product just to check that if anything had been updated. And then also once the recording is uploaded, so once your video recorded session is uploaded and saved in the product, which you can do automatically if you're using that Kajabi scheduler, then both the coach and the client are going to get notified because I've got that all ticked here. So that is a fantastic new update to the coaching product, and it's just making it amazing. Okay, next up, I want to show you this amazing new feature in the email campaigns, and that is some folders. We're getting some organization within Kajabi, and we're hoping the folders are going to roll out to other parts of Kajabi soon as well. But basically, up until now, when you came into emails, you literally had a whole list of all the past emails you've sent. And as you can see, I've got a lot. So if there's a particular email you're wanting to go back and find to resend, it was just a little bit messy. This is a mixture of email broadcasts, email sequences, and event emails. So all of them here. Now what we can do is we can filter for all of those. We can filter for the status, so anything that's scheduled or in draft mode. And then we can add them to folders now as well. So if I just add this one here, I can see it's not in a folder. I can see these ones are, you can see here, or I can click over to here and see the actual folders that I've set up. And you can see how many emails are in each folder. So I've got a whole heap of event emails archived in this folder. If I look at my weekly emails, I know that I could add some more to that. So this week I just sent my weekly email yesterday, which is this one here. So I can now click on this and you'll see this little box pop up down the bottom with some actions, and I can go add to folder, and I can choose which folder I want to add it to, which is the weekly emails, and go save. So that's just a little bit of order from the chaos. Now we still see the big long list of emails when we first come in to your email marketing area. However, you can flick over to this one and just have a look at the templates once that starts getting all organized. It's very exciting. We're hoping that this will roll out for landing pages and for offers soon as well, because there's the same kind of list, big long list available in there. Of course, you can always search in each of those functions for things if you know the name of them, but having some folders is certainly exciting for most of us. And the final exciting update right now is that for those using the branded mobile app, which is your own customized app that Kajabi build for you, you are now able to take subscription payments through your own app. So if you have the app, then you've probably only been able to sell things that are just one payment, like a full payment, or maybe payment plans as well. But now you can have subscriptions, which is perfect for those with memberships and communities, and really nice functioning app that will just automatically flow for your customers. So that's super exciting as well. If you're interested in getting the mobile branded app, it's an additional fee on top of your Kajabi membership. However, it is very affordable compared to building your own app. So make sure you jump into your Kajabi dashboard. You'll be able to find a place to inquire about it and get the ball moving, work with Kajabi, or here in this help center as well. If you just type in branded mobile app, BMA is the acronym for it, then you'll be able to find some information and get started on it as well. So that is all the updates. It's a wrap on Kajabi's latest features. What do you think? Are those updates something that's going to be useful in your business? I hope so. Let me know in the comments below and I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you're thinking about starting with Kajabi, I've got an exclusive deal just for you. When you sign up using my link in the description below, you're going to get my exclusive best deal with Kajabi. At the very minimum, that's a 30-day free trial. Kajabi only offers a 14-day free trial. Plus, you're going to get three of my bonuses, including a support call with me to help you get up and running. You can grab the deal in the description below. And if you found this video helpful, please don't forget to hit like and subscribe for more Kajabi tips and online business strategies. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more tips on online business in Kajabi. Got questions? Drop them in the comments below. I'd love to help.